to this one, I'm gonna talk really, I don't know, finding another, it was something else I was gonna talk about, but it went out the window. But I'm gonna talk about distractions instead. That's probably why I went out the window. Distractions. Now, distractions are, they can be, just pretty much a standard set of day-to-day routines, a standard set of this person and that person communicating and their particular friendship, that can be a distraction. And I mean not anything about, how shall I say it? Communication with other human beings can be a distraction. So these are all pools. These are all pools off your higher mountain, your higher spiritual mountain. You're on your spiritual path. You are trying to get yourself to some kind of clarity of understanding. But then you have another communication with another human being, and oftentimes it's back into the generalization lifespan. And when you have that communication pool back into this generalization, oh, I'm going to the movies, I have to go to the store, I have to go to the doctor, all of these things, these are communication pulls off of your spiritual mountain. And when I mean spiritual mountain, you're really in a clarity. Everything up there, not an eclair, with a big fat lollop on top, but you really are on top of that mountain. You are not disturbed. You're not having distractions. Not having distractions at all. But when these others take at you, literally they take at you, they're taking, this is the element of their routine and your involvement in their routine. And so there you go into the generalizations. And that usually is just like, and then this is life and this is death and this is how we do it in the middle, this is the routine in the middle, those little, and this is you go to the dentist, and that's definitely pulling you off that mountain, you know, that'll be one of those distractions in the middle, and they have to go to this place, or I have to go to that place, you know, get in my car a lot, that'll be a distraction in the middle. All of these things are taking away from your spiritual who you are. You just really are. Now, I'm not saying, you know, sit in the corner and just become a big fat guru either, because that's not so good. If getting your car is exercise, that obviously helps your spiritual clarity later. But yeah. But I'm talking about the distractions that are received. And it's like, okay, so how do you separate? How do you separate your brain when you're getting this flow, this of all these general sets, the general set of what's this is a have to do. This is a have to do. You know, so that's okay. It's a have to do. I have to renew my DMV something. That's pulling me off my spiritual mountain for sure. When I'm looking at DMV, I'm like, well, there's not really any way I can look at that spiritually as much as I have tried, you know. I just can't. It's just a yank off of that mountain. Okay, so there is the DMV in that general set. Again, the lifespan set. And it's like, what a bore. What an absolute total bore. When I get back into the generalization lifespan set, dentists and DMVs, I mean, what an absolute chore. that people live in this, their spiral, that's their life spiral. I'm like, and ever so often, maybe there's a party, maybe a wedding, or something that's exciting, ever so often. But mostly it's these other things, it's these other chores. It's chores of, and a lot of it's government. The government has us set to just march, man. We are marching to this government tune all the time. And I don't care what state you're in, America, or what country you're in, Europe. You are marching to a lot of government tones. You have to have adherences done by them on time. You know, you can't have your own freedom. But wait, you know, I'm on my mountain, my spiritual mountain. I didn't want to think about a renewal. I didn't want to think about how I have to have the insurance exactly on this day. And then the audacity, here I am in this generalization span. There was a little tiny check for $4 from a government, and it was a 2013. And I'm like, well, gosh, how wonderful. So I went and I put it into the bank account, and it bounced. It was like too late. And so the little $4 check from the government, the California, went and became $12 that it cost. So that $12 check eventually then turned the whole, all of my banking into an overdraft, which cost $35. And so after the $35, I had to go to the bank and tell them, no, that was wrong, because the car was in the shop and there's nothing that I could do. And so here's the $35. Luckily, they gave it back, but the $12 not. You know, so the little $4 from California became $12 you owe. So yeah, so those little things, you know, these are not spiritual. This is nothing about guidance. This is nothing about clarity, nothing about learning who you are. This is nothing about the mountain of being on your own Goliath. It's none of that. This is about, what the heck? Why am I owned by these mundanes? Why are these mundanes the owner? You know, how dare they? You know, and I don't want to step every step of my walk in the day and go, how dare they, how dare they? But I do. I live and breathe it. How dare they? Anyway, so that's where I'm at right now. There are